The entire world literally changed in 2020 and 2021, including the world of grant writing for nonprofits. If you lead a nonprofit that relies on or hopes to apply for grants for funding for your nonprofit, you should know that grant writing changed a little bit recently. But how? In this video, I'm going to share 5 ways that grant writing for nonprofits has changed recently so that you can get up to speed and hopefully increase your odds of getting some funding to support your amazing cause. Welcome back! If this is your first time to my channel, my name is Amber Melanie Smith, and I am a founder of a nonprofit and current executive director of that nonprofit that I founded, and a YouTuber who makes these videos to help people at the beginnings of their social impact journey, especially if they're starting a nonprofit organization. I hope that you find this helpful. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and do that little thing where you ring the bell so you can get alerts next time I post a new video. I've talked about my own grant writing experience a little bit in some of my other videos, but over the course of my work in the nonprofit world, I've probably written over 100 grants, and I apply for maybe around a dozen or so each year. And over the past 12 months, I've really seen a lot of changes in how grant funders are choosing to distribute money to nonprofit organizations. Now, some of this is due to COVID-19 and the economic impacts that are related to COVID-19, but some of these changes are the culminations of conversations that have been happening in the funder world for several years now, so that's exciting. So let's get right into it. Here are the 5 biggest changes that I've seen in the way that funders are distributing funds that I've seen mostly over the past 12 months come to fruition. Number 1. Major grant funders are making their grant applications and application processes shorter and less complicated, and this is amazing news. There's been talk for years about the complexity of grant writing and applying for grants, and conversations in the funder world have surrounded this idea that it's very complex to apply for a grant, especially if you are a smaller or under-resourced organization. But especially over the past year, funders are really, really seeing the critical value that organizations of all sizes play in improving the community and addressing the community's needs, especially since COVID-19. Funders are taking greater notice, they're listening to these needs, and they're coming out with shorter, less complicated grant applications and processes to apply for grants. Woohoo! The second major change is actually kind of the other side of the coin to change number 1 that I just talked about. And that is, while funders are making grant applications and processes shorter and less complicated, they are putting more emphasis on relationships when it comes to the organizations they choose to support. I mean, think about it. No matter how grumpy you might be if you get rejected for a grant, remember that there's a human being behind the process of reading your grant application and making that decision. So knowing that person and having a relationship with them and a certain trust, especially if they're going to be asking for less detail on their grant application, can make a lot of sense. In my experience, the odds of getting a grant are higher if you have a trusting relationship with the funder that you are applying for a grant from. No one expects to be best friends with grant foundation people. I mean, I'm sure that they have some wonderful best friends, but you don't have to be very close with someone to get the funding. It shouldn't be about who you know, but it is about trust, especially if you're going to be applying for grants that are less complicated and require less data. This can be good news. It means that in order to increase your odds of getting a grant, you can work on cultivating meaningful relationships with people in your community to include potential funders. It can mean that you work on having a good reputation and operate with integrity and honor. And all of those things will go a long way to make sure that you can get the funding you need to support your cause. The third major change is that grant funders are finally starting to put more emphasis on diversity, equity, and inclusion. Recently, funders are working harder to make sure that they are getting support to those underrepresented, underserved, under-resourced organizations that might have less access to funding support than other organizations. And they also are paying attention to the organizations that are made up of leadership that represents the communities that they serve. Funders want to make sure that the organizations they support have the infrastructure, policies, program processes, and leadership in place to make sure that everyone in the community can access the services of the organization as they apply. Another element of this is that funders are also devoting more resources to helping organizations actually develop robust plans to improve their diversity, equity, and inclusion. As you start to apply for more grants over the next couple of years, expect to see more and more questions about this on those grant applications. The fourth major change is that a lot of funders are shifting their funding priorities and their focus areas to focus on some of the major big issues that have been especially illuminated as a result of COVID-19 and its economic impacts. These are issues like chronic homelessness, food insecurity, education, unemployment, access to healthcare, and more. Funders are becoming more and more interested in supporting organizations that have big, brilliant ideas for how to attack and ultimately solve these problems at their roots. And building in systems to create resilient communities who can be stronger in the event another pandemic or other type of disaster occurs and affects our communities again. And the fifth major change, and I'm honestly super excited about this one, is that more and more funders are starting to see the value in funding general operating support as opposed to strictly narrowing their focus on funding programs or specific projects. I have talked about this in lots of other videos, but nonprofits need strong infrastructure and strong foundations in order to be able to do the critical and difficult work that they do. So funders are seeing the light on this a little bit more and being more open and willing to fund needs that are part of the infrastructure, like staff positions, office space, equipment, and more. Like I said, this is a big shift from past years, and it's going to go a long way in building the capacity of organizations who, let's be frank, are kind of saving the world right now. Those are the five biggest ways that I have seen grant writing for nonprofits change over the past 12 months. I'd love to hear from you. Is grant funding part of your nonprofit funding strategy right now? What other shifts in grant funding have you seen over the past year or more? Share in the comments below. I hope that you found this video helpful. Like I said before, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and all that good stuff for more videos like this. Also, if you are looking for resources or help starting a nonprofit, don't forget to check out my website. The link for that is in the description below, but I am launching some special online courses and resources that are specifically tailored to folks getting started with their nonprofit journey. Be sure to check that out. Final thing, if you are on Facebook, don't forget to check out my group, Change the World or Bust. We've got lots of folks from all over the world in there talking about our social impact adventures and helping each other out. Once again, I'm Amber Melanie Smith, and I hope to see you next time. Thanks, bye.